Hey, I'm Lizzy with Vevo. We're here in New York City at the flower shop, and I'm about to talk to Dagny about her breakout EP, Ultraviolet, and about upcoming tours and what she has in store for us. I'm so stoked to finally sit down with you and meet you properly, because we have so many mutual friends, and we only met very briefly when you played the Vevo party a couple months ago.
Yeah, that was good.
Which was wonderful. Because I've been living with the EP for so long, it was really interesting seeing you perform it, because it has like a little bit more of like a rock and roll vibe live, I think, necessarily than it sounds like on the EP.
Yeah, that's true. We get a lot of feedback on that, being like, when you come to a show, it's very energetic.
Yeah. Now that you've been touring this EP, and sort of like feeling the bones of what it feels like to be like more raucous and raw, do you think that's going to change like the direction of how the album develops?
We're constantly like developing and changing.
Yeah.
And with the live show as well, like if you saw us like 6 months ago, it would be quite a different show from what it is now. And I feel like the same about the music. And the more that I get to write and travel and see how people respond, the more I can become more confident in myself.
Yeah.
And like when I go into a session, I think sometimes for me the hardest thing is to just believe that the idea is good.
Yeah.
Because it can be hard. When you're in session, you know, you're not in front of the audience. You don't see how they react. You're just in the moment, and sometimes I need to like live with it for a little bit to realize like, does this feel good? Is it right? Am I in love with this or not?
Have you always written in English, or do you also write in Norwegian?
No, I don't actually write in Norwegian, which I feel like there's a few things that change when I write in Norwegian. It's like, it gets a lot more like nature-inspired, poetic. I don't know.
That's interesting.
Yeah, and it's like when you say something in Norwegian, for me, when I say something in Norwegian, it suddenly feels a lot more personal. Like if I say to you, like, I love you, if feels like a very different thing to say than if I would say like "elsk" that, which is how I would say.
Also, comedy translates and meaning and emotion translates so differently, like in the context.
It's so true. When I moved to a new country as like a 21-year-old, I remember feeling so stupid because I didn't speak the language that well.
Yeah.
And I remember just thinking like, oh my god, you must think I'm just super dumb right now. But it was just like a translation thing. It was like, yeah, that took a time to get over that. When I'm with you, I feel like wearing nothing,
nothing at all. And you just recently released Wearing Nothing, and the video is awesome.
Thank you.
I love it. I read very Wes Anderson influenced.
Yep.
What is that process like of translating your songs to a visual medium like?
When you first hear a song after you wrote it, you get all these, like in my head, I always get all these images. But then it's like another, year until you release it, or like maybe 8 months or 6 months. So by the time you're then coming up with the video, you've heard it so much that it's like hard to come up with something. But, you know, meeting Tabitha, she was just like, so I'm kind of thinking Wes Anderson, or, you know, talking about these things. And I was like, yes. And she was like, and then I want you to like, you know, synchronized dancing with another, like a partner, and like quite quirky stuff. And I was like, yes! I just never thought that anyone was gonna be able to like actually make a video that felt like something that I had
that's
in my
so
head.
That's so awesome. I think that's like the most satisfying feeling.
Yeah. When I'm with you, I feel like wearing nothing.
Feeling side of side of two. What are some goals you would dream of fulfilling for the future?
I want to go on a massive bus tour around America.
Yeah.
I've never done that. So it's like, I need to do that very soon. I did my first headlining tour this year, and playing for your own audience, it's such a different experience.
Yeah.
So actually, you know, I just want to be on a stage with like lots of people who just really wants to be there and listen to my music, and then I'm a happy person.
Well, I can't wait to hear new music. I love everything I've heard and seen to date, and I've already seen you live, and you crush it, and I can't wait to see you more.
Thank you. Bit of a mindfuck, like writing on my own language.
So are you writing in Norwegian?
Dude.
I love it. I think the foghorn is like excitement. You
know?
Like, he really brings the club and the excitement to the interview. Run it back.